Hello, everybody, and welcome back to more DGS2 DLC time in London, at least. And probably the last video for this DLC and just DGS in general, and I'm just making myself sad again. But before we get to that point, we need to be presenting something about the odd blackness in the chalice, which we can prove with this pocket watch, which is also very black. So we, there's probably something in that chalice that caused it to turn black, so let's find out. Junior Detective Gregson, it would seem that once again, there's one large contradiction in your testimony.
What?
The thing that exposes that contradiction is Mr. Narahodo's watch here.
What? Attorney Narahodo's watch?
Yeah. The important point here is the type of metal that goes black when tarnished. When pure silver comes into contact with sulfur, it turns black. Which means that there was nothing cheap about the stolen chalice. At least that's how Narahodo would answer. How would Sherlock answer? Now, Junior Detective, I believe you said earlier that the stolen chalice was a cheap bit of rubbish that wouldn't fetch a good price.
Yeah, what of it?
The important thing isn't the price, it's the memories it contains. And that goes double for memories of a failed attempt in one's life with poison.
Poison?
Precisely. That chalice almost saw Reapy here to an early grave. Sent Reapy? Huh? What? Are you saying that memory is worthless?
Huh? Well, I mean...
Holmes-san, can I say something? You again, Mr. Narahodo. What is it this time? That's a completely different contradiction from the one I had in mind. Then let me ask you this. What do you think was the true nature of the tarnish on the stolen chalice? Wouldn't it have been sulfur?
Sulfur?
This is something that everyone in the world but you know, apparently, but... Narahodo! If silver is exposed to sulfur, it tarnishes and goes black.
What?
Please look at my pocket watch. I took it with me on a hot spring trip with my friend, and by the time we headed home, it had turned this color.
How unfortunate.
So, the reason the stolen chalice went black was...
It was probably because the prosecutor was lounging in the hot spring and sipping from one of his...
Don't think I would ever commit the same folly as you would.
Wow. Besides, if that were the case, the tarnish would be on the outside of the chalice. Yeah. Funny imagery, but sorry, Narahodo.
So then what on earth caused it to tarnish like that?
I know. It was probably arsenic.
Arsenic?
You mean the stuff that bad guys always use in novels to try to assassinate the king? Narahodo!
Exactly. It's a tasteless, scentless poison. So it's always been a favorite drug for little assassins.
One or two mouthfuls of ornate food or choice wine and then it's all over. You can't mean that Prosecutor Van Zeeks was...
Indeed I was. I noticed just in time, though.
Thank you. Does that mean that sharp nose of yours picked up the scent of the arsenic? As Iris just said, arsenic is flavorless and scentless. Besides, this is the man who sniffed that glass over and over and still didn't realize it was tea in there. There's no way he noticed with a nose that dull. Ouch, that sick burn.
Girl.
So then how did he...
All those kings weren't willing to sit idly by and let themselves be killed off. They began taking preventative measures of their own. Something like a good luck charm.
What was it? Pure silver dishes.
Pure silver. That's true. You do always picture powerful people eating with silver forks and knives. Is that really why they use silver? It wasn't just for the beauty, it also had a more practical reason. Huh, I learned something today. I believe everyone here ought to be able to see where this is headed, right?
I see. Silver doesn't just react to sulfur, it also reacts to deadly poisons.
I expected as much from you, Junior Detective. That was just the answer I expected you to give. But there's no way, as if such a convenient metal exists. Poor Detective Gregson. The important point here lies in how arsenic is made.
How arsenic is made? There's a type of mineral known as arsenopyrite. It's a sulfide compound of arsenic and iron. Iron!
Right. That's Iris Chan for you.
If you crush arsenopyrite, pyrite?
Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Oh! Words! Even worse, I'm trying to do it with Iris's voice.
Arsenopyrite and fire it in a kiln. Then let the vapor cool, it becomes arsenic crystals. But see, once that happens, it's not pure anymore, and always causes sulfur to form.
Sulfur. Oh! With our current technology, we weren't able to completely remove sulfur from arsenic. So then... If you put a dose of arsenic on a silver dish, the silver reacts with the composition of the sulfur, and the dish tarnishes black. Well, it isn't clear exactly how effective it is, but at the very least, it was effective enough to save Reepy.
Ugh.
This knowledge is so well known among members of the judicial system that you could even call it common sense. It's impossible for a detective to not know it. Isn't that right?
Huh? No, well...
When you saw this pure silver chalice on display in the office on the chessboard, and unintentionally reached for it, that's what we can assume. Home-san is an odd one, alright. After hearing his deduction just now, I finally feel like now, we know at last who the true thief is. Your Honor.
Yes, Defense?
The Defense would like to indicate the name of the true thief in this case.
What? The true thief? Huh?
Interesting. Just who does this legal aid on probation intend to accuse? I suppose I'll hear you out.
In that case, Mr. Naruhodo, throw it in all their faces! Right! The true thief responsible for stealing Prosecutor Van Zeek's silver chalice is... Sherlock Holmes. It was you! Sherlock Holmes-san!
What? Holmesy?
What? Why me? The stolen chalice was displayed on the chessboard. Is that true, Prosecutor Van Zeeks?
Yes, indeed it was.
There's no way he could have known that unless he'd seen the chalice in the office. So, how did you know, Holmes-san? That's true. Now that you mention it, how did I know? Huh? I've been so busy thinking about Iris that I completely forgotten. But now that you mention it, I came to have some fun at the prosecutor's office and peeked in on Reapy's office. But that was 10 days ago. It can't be related to this case.
Hold it. You. What did you just say? Did you say you peeked into my office?
Now. I'm a busy man, after all, you see. I completely forgot it until just now.
You will tell us everything that happened at that time. Every last detail, with honesty.
Now he's on the witness stand? Holmes! Very well. I was just starting to get into a chatty mood. What on earth is going on here? A circus. That day, my eyes fell upon it in Reapy's office. By which I mean the famous Lord's bottle, sitting right on top of his desk. Anyone would want to try a sip, right? I was no different. He took the... So I poured some into a rubbishy-looking old chalice sitting on the chessboard.
What?
Holmes. And what do you think happened next? I noticed that the bottom of the inside of the chalice had gone all black. Oh my god, did Charlotte just save Baroque? There was a fair bit of terrifying arsenic hidden in that bottle. Think of that, I hurriedly poured the contents of the bottle out the window. What? But that chalice. Yes, I noticed it then too. The tarnish on the chalice had been there for many years. But I'd already dumped the Lord's bottle out the window by that time, you see? So I filled it back up with tea and put it back among the other bottles. Tea? Yeah, Iris always makes me a flask when I go out. By the way, I put the bottle with the tea in it carefully back on the shelf. And you finally drew the winning bottle just today, apparently.
I'm going to strangle you, Holmes.
It was 10-day-old tea, after all. Of course it tasted awful. Oh my... I'm sorry, I got lost in that.
Don't you me. Damn you. Don't tell me. That's when you made off with my chalice?
Yeah, come to think of it, I slipped it into my pocket and brought it home with me. Why would you do such a thing? I couldn't help being bothered by the tarnish. I thought I'd shine it up for you. What a nice man, but also... Why are you only telling us all this now? Well, I already said... Didn't I? This all happened 10 days ago. This definitely happened 3 days ago. How could it possibly be related?
To be honest, I don't check every day to make sure that my chalice is still on the chessboard.
So it just so happened to be 3 days ago that you noticed it was missing. Is that what you mean? Yeah, well, I didn't think you meant that chalice. Why didn't you say so sooner?
How many tarnished old silver chalices do you think I have?
I suppose you're right. You got me there. Oh my... Holmes, I want to strangle you.
10 years ago. The Grim Reaper made his first appearance here in the Old Bailey. After a 3-day trial, the not guilty verdict was handed down, and the villain ended up losing his life to falling rocks at a construction site. And that was the beginning of my unending battle against the criminals of this city. At the time, I was in the habit of using an old silver chalice I'd inherited from my father. The trial began, and as soon as I unsuspectingly tipped my chalice, a chill ran down my spine. The bottom of the chalice had gone black.
Apparently, some criminal had secretly wiped some arsenic along the inside of your chalice.
It was all a complete coincidence. The fact that my chalice was silver, as well as the fact that I had just happened to look inside the cup before I drank.
The true identity of the Grim Reaper is Lord Baroque Van Zeeks. Thinking that, the villain's comrades tried to get revenge on you. But...
when the trial ended that day, I made a decision. I decided that from that point forward, I was going to take these villains head on. And so at the end of that day, I sealed away the silver suit of armor that had protected me.
Suit of armor? He must mean the chalice.
That's when I began using these transparent glass chalices instead. I will fight fair in all things, and my taste in chalices reflects that resolve.
Oh, how very fitting now. It suddenly has... I love the things you never expect to learn. Why does Baroque Van Zeeks use glass chalices?
Dear Lord.
It's been 10 years, but in the end, I was never able to catch the one responsible for coating my chalice with poison. That chalice is filled with those bitter memories.
I appreciate how, even though him breaking chalices is a gimmick, it is also treated as not a gimmick. And it is impressive that they managed to do that. Ah, yes, regarding your beloved chalice, after bringing it home with me, I did a thorough investigation on it of my own.
What?
Well, it ended up being quite difficult. I had to lift 10 years worth of fingerprints from it and analyze them, you see?
What? Is that even possible?
Yes, it took longer than expected, but... this morning I caught the criminal responsible. It was a Mr. Devin Musgrave. What? I heard that name out in the lobby this morning. It was the younger brother of the major criminal who lost his life at the hands of the Grim Reaper 10 years ago. Mr. Meikare Musgrave. Oh, I now understand this pun now. So, like, I know I put the notes up at this point. It's not here for me, but my translator did change their names. It is still, it still fits them. It's just changed a little bit so it actually sounds like what they are in English. So Devin Musgrave and Maycare Musgrave. So it reads as Devil Maycare with their names. Musgrave is still the same, but their first names have been changed to suit their characters. And it still works out. Now I get it. I was trying to figure out why is it Devin when we first started this anyway. He admitted to coating your chalice with poison.
When I heard you say the name Moosgrave this morning, I thought it couldn't possibly be.
Naturally! I'm sure you were highly suspicious of him yourself at the time, after all.
But why on earth did you?
I said it before, did I not? I couldn't help being bothered by the tarnish on the silver, and figure I'd shine it up for you. In his Holmes way, Sherlock Holmes way, Holmes-san.
It seems as though all the mysteries have become clear.
All thanks to Mr. Holmes. I think most of this was Mr. Holmes' fault in the first place, though. Yeah, we only just remembered.
In that case, defendant, Iris Watson.
Yes.
I will now hand down your final verdict.
I don't believe there's any more need for a verdict.
Lord Van Zeeks?
This was a special trial which was held because of my personal complaint. If I drop the charges, that will be the end of it.
Understood.
Miss Watson, are you all right with that? I am terribly sorry for the injustice I have done to you. Please, forgive me.
On one condition.
Condition?
You have a second Lord's bottle there. If you just promise to take good care of it, I'll forgive you.
What do you mean, take good care?
You never learn, do you, Reapy?
What?
Times like these are the best times for enjoying a sip. Times like these are the best times for enjoying a sip. Maybe that means there's some of Iris Chan's tea in there.
I have never felt so afraid. It's empty.
All according to plan.
There's something in there. Huh? What does she mean by that?
Now then, Reapy, take good care of it, okay?
Oh, all right.
In that case, this trial is hereby adjourned.
With Prosecutor Van Zees continually cocking his head, the curtain closed on this crazy trial. Now, for me personally, I looked at the other Asinine episode and the way it plays out. I find both of these canon. Like, they're more straightforward than the DGS1's ones, in my opinion. Because there are some moments where they kind of broke the meta in the DGS1's shorts. And there are some character stuff, but I'm like, okay, that makes sense. But then they do some weird stuff, and I'm just like, is that actually canon or not? But for the most part, I feel, approaching both of these Asinine episodes, I'm pretty sure they're pretty canon. At least to it, giving more about the characters, so... Same day, 11:12 a.m., Old Bailey's Defendant's Lobby.
Thank you, Narahoda-kun and Holmesy.
Congrats, Iris Chan.
That trial ended sooner than I thought it would. This means we'll be perfectly in time for afternoon tea.
I said so, didn't I, Iris? As far as I'm concerned, defending is nothing more remarkable than a yawn before breakfast. I can't help thinking that's not exactly true. But in the end, there's still one mystery remaining. The Hulk? You really did enter his office 3 days ago, right?
Well, I ended up being spotted as I was trying to leave, see?
So, what in the world were you trying... were you doing in Prosecutor Van Zeek's office?
Actually...
Pardon me.
Prosecutor Van Zeek's!
There was something I couldn't help wondering about, so I came to ask you. What exactly was the story behind that Lord's bottle earlier?
Happy birthday!
Huh?
Oh. Today's your birthday, right, Reepy?
Right, I suppose it is.
Did she really? My suspect information network can dig up practically anything! So then, does that mean...
Yeah, I thought up a lot of different approaches. The prosecutor's office isn't open on the weekends, so I had no choice but to go 3 days ago. I calculated how many bottles Reepy would throw over the course of these past 3 days. And made my choice so that he'd pick up that bottle on his birthday trial.
Holy crap, Iris! That's mega brain, holy crap! So then, the bottle you tried to pour wine from earlier, are you saying it was a birthday present?
Yep, Reepy always looks so lonely by himself, see?
Oh my god, she is so perceptive! Bless! Oh my god, I can't- Oh, I'm sorry, I can't. She is so- Oh my god! Apparently those words from a little girl cut him unexpectedly deep. But why an empty bottle?
It wasn't empty.
Huh?
There was something strange about it, so I peeked inside and found this.
This?
Well, Reepy, you promised me, okay?
What? Oh my!
You promised me that you'll take good care of Van Zeekski.
Oh my god! You see why I waited until the end of DGS2 now? You can fully, like, appreciate this whole scene right here. That's so adorable. Is it also like the charms that, you know, the Chunosuke and the rabbit and stuff? Can you like, is it like a radio? Can Iris talk to Broker through that? And that's how it is. Any objections, Reepy?
No, not particularly. Pardon me. I need to return to the prosecutor's office.
Oh, he's embarrassed. Alright, so... I'll see it when I get there. It looks like everything kind of fell into place in the end, huh? I'm kind of moved. Yeah, I guess. Except for one thing. Huh? After all, there's no mistaking that we broke into the good prosecutor's office. And there's a fine for that. Of £5. I'm sure Baroque could probably excuse it. That's pretty high. Oh no, I know what's gonna happen. They're gonna ask Naruhodo to pay for it. How about moving your wallet in addition to your feelings? Pay up!
Yeah, pay up!
So that's how it's gonna be. Well, I figure out how to make the final act exciting for you, see? I went through quite a lot of trouble making everything flow smoothly. In that case, excuse me.
Oh, I knew it! You just gotta end with one of those!
Attorney Naruhodo's pre-launch shout! Do it nice and loud now! And that's the end. Oh, bless. I hope all of you had good warm fuzzy feelings after that, because what a good episode. What a good, like, in-depthness of everything. And what I was going to say in the middle of that is that Baroque's birthday is apparently somewhere in the middle of Narhoma's probation. So somewhere in the middle of that gap between case 5 into case 3 of DGS2 is his birthday. When is it? I don't know, because I can't remember for the life of me the date for DGS2 case 3 at this point. But there you go. London Side, DLC episode starring Sherlock and Baroque. Bless. I just have warm fuzzy feelings at the end of that. But anyway, that is it. I'm done. There's nothing more for me to share for DGS now. I'm very sad it is over. But I thank all of you who came through this journey. I really do appreciate you guys staying for as long as I have, because this has been, when did we start DGS1? I'm really just talking at this point, because literally there's nothing else now. I guess I could tell you what else I'm doing, but at this point in time, I am not doing any more big projects for a while, because I have been doing non-stop big projects since Project Cross Zone 2, which I recommend you guys checking that out. That one had a huge voice crew, and a lot of the voice crew from there, they continued on to do my Ace Attorney stuff up to this point. And I think we're all, you know, I think they all deserve a break. And I'm gonna take a break too. Yeah, that's it. I would love to do more Ace Attorneys, because there's still plenty of Ace Attorney stuff to go through, like, that I'm missing, but at this point in time, I guess an Ace Attorney hiatus is probably the best way to put it. Or maybe I could sit down and put, like, a proper insight of how I feel about the series. I don't know if that would interest you guys, where, like, I just sit and talk about it. I don't know. But for now, that's it. I'm just sad it's over. It's such a good game. It's a really good game. And I still see Capcom supporting this. Like, not game, but merchandise. There's so much merchandise that is, like, coming out for this series. And they sell out real fast, funny enough. So, like, there's still some inkling of support from Capcom, but I don't think there's gonna be anything more with this game. Considering how, you know, it didn't sell quite as well. But I'm just happy that I was able to experience this game. You know, it's hard for a game that's not, like, fully translated. Even with the fan translation Scarlet Study has, it's very limited. You need to have an Android, you need to have a Homebrew 3DS to make it work. And, you know, not everyone's gonna have that. So, like, I'm happy I got to go through it. I'm happy I was able to share this game with you guys, and, you know, but maybe you don't agree with all my thoughts in the game, but, you know, that's fine. We all have our own opinions, and I'm just happy you guys got to experience it. You guys got to know what this game is about, and, you know, please, like, it's done now. Might as well just share to other people and, you know, let them binge through the whole thing. I feel like I want to go through, like, the beginning of the game again, just because, you know, everything's been solved. Everything's here now. But yeah, that's it. I thank you, everyone who is still here with me through this entire journey. I will do more stuff in the future, but for now, it's an Ace Attorney hiatus, you know, for a bit of time. And that's it. Until next time, then. Whatever videos I end up posting.
How many tarnished old silver... Tarnished? Tarnished. I'm not American.